I'm entomologist, educator, entertainer,
award-winning film producer, Antonio Gusti.
Antonio Gusti.
Do I really need to go with this? Yeah. Now this video is part one of two for this GoFundMe proposal. In part two, you're gonna see the what and how of what it is I wish to create, but I felt compelled to make a video to tell you why it is I wanted to create this in the first place. See, I don't see this so much as a business proposal as I do a sustainable way to change the world.
To change the world.
Because make no mistake about it, that is my vision. That is my goal. That is what this is all about. I want to change the world, and I want to do it through your children. I want to do it by teaching them the intellectual tools that lifted us from the dark ages, the tools that got us to the moon, that figured out the theory of relativity, gravity, discovered penicillin, evolution. And that tool is science.
Science. Science. Sure, what you're about to see is a proposal for what looks like a very cool insect slash reptile exhibit with some extras, and it looks like kids are just having a lot of fun. So what? Why is this important? What this really is, in essence, is an interactive natural science park.
Interactive natural science park.
In the guise of a very cool insect slash reptile exhibit. It is a place where kids will feel excited to come see the creatures that we exhibit, interact with them, and then go explore and find their own. Again, so what? Why is this important? It just looks like they're playing with bugs and screwing around. Now, for the last 20 years, I've been running a program called Tony's Creepy Crawly Zoo. It was a traveling, hands-on, live insect exhibit that I brought to over a million kids in that time. I made them laugh, I made them scream, and in the end I brought live insects and other arthropods that they all got to take out and home. And why did I do it?
Because this is what it looks like. Sure, I'm a grown man and I take life very seriously, but inside, this is my face too. And this is the face inside of all of these people as well. See these faces? These are the faces that inspired their whole lives. See these faces? This is where science starts, with curiosity. And I will bet that every single one of these people can trace their lives back to the day they made a face like this. The face that said, I want to know more.
I want to know more. And this is it. This is my goal. I want to know more.
That is what this proposal is all about.
See, these scientists are these kids inside, and these kids can grow up to be these scientists.
Or at the very least, lead fulfilling, well-adjusted lives in the pursuit of knowledge, no matter what it is they choose to do.
The only difference between here and here is science.
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 Science, science, science!
And science begins with curiosity, with asking questions. The only difference between these kids and these scientists is that these people never stopped asking questions.
Can you imagine how annoying they must have been as kids?
Now, for those of you who don't understand what science is or where I'm going with this, let me explain what science is. See, science is not a thing. It is not a body of knowledge, and scientists are not those guys.
Science is life. Science is everything.
Science is a way of thinking that helps us understand our existence and checking ourselves, separating what's real from what just makes us feel good. Science is humanity's candle in the dark. It is a very simple intellectual tool to guide our ability to reason and solve problems. Now here are the tenets of science, so eloquently laid down over 1,000 years ago by the Islamic scholar Al-Hazen. And recently reillustrated in the series Cosmos by Neil deGrasse Tyson.
And I would personally like to take this moment to thank both Neil deGrasse Tyson, Seth MacFarlane, and everybody involved in making the series Cosmos. It was masterfully done. Thank you. And I hope there's gonna be another season.
Now teach your children to follow these tenets when answering questions, along with their ability to reason, and your children will be unstoppable.
Unstoppable!
Unstoppable.
Now this is where my venture and science connect. See, when I first started the Creepy Crawly Zoo, I realized something right away. I couldn't answer everyone's questions, but I sure did inspire them. My audiences always wanted more. And at first, I thought this was a flaw. But then after dozens and dozens of letters from parents complaining that they couldn't take family vacations anymore without packing the nets and jars, well, I realized that I had done something. I had lit the fires of curiosity and wonder. And I also realized how perfect insects were as a tool for this, because after I left, they could go do this on their own, anywhere. See, insects are the most dominant life form on the planet. They are everywhere, and they affect everything. No child has to go anywhere to observe insects. They're weird, they're exciting, they're awe-inspiring, they're mysterious. They are the roller coaster in the theme park. Entomology is what I like to call a gateway science.
Gateway science.
See, through entomology, questions can lead to chemistry, evolution, biology, zoology,
physics, botany, history, etymology, horticulture,
pathology, medicine, forensics,
Latin, Greeks, genetics, math, statistics, food science,
etc., 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 and even astronomy.
That's right, astronomy. How do you think they navigate at night?
See, my point is that using insects to inspire curiosity can lead down many roads. They are the greatest tool I know of to inspire young minds. They are the first dot in a lifetime of connecting dots. And see, I'm not out to create new entomologists. My vision is to use insects to create a population of well-adjusted, problem-solving thinkers. Thinkers. Otherwise known as scientists. Now, the place I want to create is only guised as an insect reptile exhibit, but it is a place dedicated to changing the world via science. A place dedicated to your children. A place that both children and adults will want to return to again and again and never even realize they're learning. The sciences and the tenets of science will be incorporated into all that we do. I even found a way to incorporate math into our trail structure. Some of you will know what this is. Now imagine a facility that excites, educates, and inspires. Imagine a local population of curious, excited children who possess the intellectual tools to pursue their curiosities. Young citizen scientists. The tools of science can take a simple child's question to an answer that can change the whole world, the human race. Think I'm being dramatic? Think I'm exaggerating?
History is full of these examples. For instance, what's this mole doing on my petri dish? I wonder what it would be like to ride on a beam of light. What are these lines between the colors on the spectrum?
And why does electricity affect a compass? Now, do these sound like super intellectual, genius questions? No! They're the questions of a child! Any child! Your child! But the answer to these questions lifted all of humanity to another level, and the answers were found via science. Science.
Science.
Science. Will it be your child who asks the next great question? And if they do, will they have the ability to answer it? Not only is this a facility to create new thinkers, but new educators as well. Our interns, volunteers, and employees will also be learning new methods of teaching science, of inspiring questions, and they too are going to go on to do greater and bigger things and take what they've learned with them.
All right, okay. I could go on forever about my love for science and what it can do for all of us, but let me wrap this up.
Society is not going to raise the bar for us. We have to do that for ourselves. Richard Branson once said that a company is a group of people coming together to make other people's lives better. I think of that when I go forward with this proposal. Not in the finished product, but right here, right now, with all of you watching this. This is where we come together to make something like this a reality. This is where changing the world starts, and it does so one donation at a time. When you see the next video, you're gonna realize that the amount I'm asking for is by no means enough to finish this project. But it is enough to get the ball unstoppably rolling. To show how massive the support is for an idea like this, you are gonna make the difference to whether or not this becomes reality. I can do this, but not without your support. So please, if I've inspired you in any way, shape, or form that you can share my vision of the future, please donate anything. $1, $5, $10. It's all going towards making the future a better place. In the next video, you're gonna see what it is that your donations will create. Join me in making the world a better place. A better place. A better place via science. Via science. And I wanna thank you in advance for your donations and also for just taking the time to watch this. Again, if you share my vision, donate. 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 Science.
Donate.
Donate. Science. Donate. Science.
I'm Antonio Gustin, the Bug Whisperer, and I approve this message.
Science.
Science.
Science, man.
Science.
Science. Oh my God, I hope there's no one watching this.